Hello all, and today I'll show you how to fix a Skype error that you get, and it says Skype failed to get proc address to get logical process information kernel32.dll. So first of all, I will show you how it looks, and this is the latest setup version of Skype. So let's remove that. I agree, I don't want these. Continue. And here we might it might take a while, but you will see the error. I downloaded this file from Skype website, and this is the newest version. I think it's 6 point, maybe, I can't remember, 6 point something, and I'm doing this video, as you can see, 16th of June 2014. So let's wait a bit. And the reason behind this error is because I run Windows XP, which is quite old, but I know some of you guys are running it as well if you're viewing this video. So let's wait, and after I will have shown you the error, I will talk about possible solutions. Essentially, there are three possible solutions to this problem. As you can see, a Skype icon has appeared here. I might actually crop some of this out, so you don't have to wait viewing the video while it's installing. Okay, something is happening. There you go, fatal error, failed to get proc address for GetLogicalProcessorInformation kernel32.dll. So let's press OK. So let's talk about the solutions. As I mentioned, there are three. And the problem occurs because Skype, the newest versions of Skype, doesn't support XP. And it says on website that it does support XP, but it supports only Service Pack 3. I'm running Service Pack 2, so that's why I cannot install the latest version of Skype. So the very first solution is simply to upgrade your XP, Windows XP, to Service Pack 3. I think using that, it should work. Another solution is to upgrade your Windows, for example, to Windows 7, Vista, or any other later version of Windows other than XP, and then you should be able to install the latest version of Skype. However, I don't think that many of you will upgrade your Windows just because of Skype. It will be because of other reasons. And the last solution is to install a older version of Skype. So first of all, you will have to uninstall the newest version, which does not work on Windows XP. So let's go and find Skype. So this was 6.16. Remove, yes, and let's wait. I will show you a website where you can get a newest, or pretty much any version of Skype. It includes many old versions and also the newest ones as well. And I will put the link in the description, so you don't have to type the whole URL. So let's wait for the uninstallment of Skype. Okay, let's close this. So let's close. Okay, so now here, oldversion.com/windows/skype, or you can just, I think, type oldversion.com, and then let's wait. My computer lags a bit. and then type here Skype. Find it. Skype. I'll put the link in the description so you can just check it out. I will put the link to here. And then here you can see many different Skype versions. And I think not all of them, but quite many. I think that the one that supports XP is, I think the latest one is 6.06 or something like that. But I downloaded this version, Skype 5.8.0.158, and I can guarantee it works. So you press that and then download, and then follow the steps. Download is here. It might be confusing because sometimes many download buttons appear. So I downloaded it and it's this one. So I simply extracted it, and here we go. And I will show you that it works. Alright, so the installation is complete. There you go, it works fine. It doesn't show those kernel32.dll errors. Simply log in and it will work fine. As I said, I'm not entirely sure. Maybe I'll check the internet and put an annotation which version is supported on XP Service Pack 2 and older service packs other than Service Pack 3. So I hope you enjoyed it. This I will put the link to this website in the description, and hopefully you'll get your Skype to work. See you guys next time.